These days, most people have access to the internet at home and increasingly out and about, using smartphones and other mobile technology. While this has obvious advantages, it has also led to a growth in cyberbullying. Whereas only bullying was confined to school or the way home from school, now bullies can attack at any time of the day or night, sending unpleasant messages or posting photographs on their victims on blogs and websites. In the past, a bully may have told a dozen people your secret. Now they can tell thousands. In a recent case, a boy who had made a silly video of himself found that the video had been posted on the internet by his classmates. William downloaded it, and the embarrassment that result from this caused the boy's teenage psychiatric health. The issue of cyberbullying is not going to go away, but there are some things which can be done to help tackle it. Firstly, individuals should try not to respond. A bully is always looking for a response, and if he or she doesn't get one, they may lose interest. However, this does not mean that the victim should ignore what is happening. It is always a good idea to tell someone about what is happening so that they can support you if the bullying gets lost. Schools should also play their part. Anti-bullying policies in schools should include cyberbullying, and all students should be aware of what this means, and that is unacceptable. If any bullying does occur, the school should deal with it as strictly as any other kind of bullying. In conclusion, cyberbullying is a serious problem and needs to be taken seriously by everyone involved.